How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop. Beam engine build. And this is similar to what we're going to make right now. This one I've completed already. It's only a little less than 3 inches long. And this is the piston rod for the aluminum steam engine. And we're going to make a connecting rod out of this 3/8 W1 drill rod, and we're going to make it will be very similar to this. It won't have the step downs here, and we'll go through the same process basically as that I made this one with, but I wanted to show you this. This came out really, really nice, and I have a bushing in there. This will be the connecting rod. This will be the from the crankshaft to the beam. Face this off. Center drill this. I have the live center in here. We're going to turn this all the way down to the pretty much the chuck to give us plenty of room, because we'll be cutting this off here. We're going to have a little extra length. We're going to turn down 3/16. Should have been the final cut. .883, .189, good enough. It's 3/16, close enough, within a thousandth, and we'll be threading down here in this end. There we go, cleaned up. Looks beautiful. Now I'm going to extend it out. We'll part it off. And then we'll be able to hold it on this small section here to do our threading. I'm just going to thread this with a die. It's quite a bit easier and just easier. So we're going to thread it all the way down here to this, which was a dimension from here to here. .1032 is the thread. We'll take that out. We'll go cut this off and we'll form the other end up. Alright, I marked this where the end needs to be. This is going to be 4/37 long, and we're just going to slip it in here and do that. I'm kind of a little long, so I'm just going to face it all off. I have a form tool in here with a 3/16 radius. This is 3/8 stock, so we're going to gently, not too fast here, and just gently form this. I'm going to first get it to rough shape with this, and then I'm going to file it to a final roundness, you might say. I mean, there's a radius gauge here, and I can check it, see what it looks like. This is a 3/16 radius. And I get a better understanding of what my form is like. That looks perfect. Awesome. Well, that looks pretty awesome and looks to be right on the money. Nice 3/8 round on there. Well, I think we're ready to take it back out and do the rest of it. We have a hole and the two sides need to... Looks pretty good. This is my dovetail setup, so I just changed the collet to a 3/16, and I'll just stick that in there with enough room to get the mill to go across here, and minimal stick out if possible. All right, I have a half inch end milling here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to take off 62 thousandths on this side, and being in here I can index it 180 degrees and 62 thousandths off the other side. We should have a quarter of an inch left. And then it's aligned, and we can come down and drill a hole. So we should be able to do all that. That's the plan. That looks really good. That's 62, and we'll just index it around. See how we did. .251. I say we did darn good. Now we'll figure out where we need to put our hole. I set this at 3/16. That'll give me halfway there, give me a nice scribe line, and the hole is also 3/16 from this end. And we just go down here, scribe a mark, and we got a cross. Line up on that cross. Okay, guess we'll pop it out of there. There we go. Came out nice. Real nice. We'll deburr it, and we need to then mark off where we need to cut this. And we'll mark it from roughly the center of the hole. There's our nice little connecting rod. Came out really nice, actually. And here's our little bushing that's going to go right in there. And I'm going to put a drop of Loctite on it. Just a touch. And oh yeah, that fits just beautiful there. And perfect. There we go. Came out nice. And our 1032 nut on there, brass nut. And then this is our other one. This one had a little bit bigger head on it for, I don't know why, but it specifications, you know. So we got that, and this one's for the aluminum engine, the small engine, and this one's for the big beam engine. And we got a little this one here now. This one, the piston goes on this one, and then this is 440 threads on here. There we go. We have a little 440 nut that'll hold the piston on there. And I also, this was a real easy one. This is the piston and piston rod for the brass engine, the beam engine. I just slipped it together to show you that one. This is the piston there for this one. There we go. So all these little parts here are completed. And we'll be moving on to the next one, next pieces. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching. And stay tuned and for the a little more on the engine. And it'll be I think we're up to the crankshaft, flywheel, and all that good stuff. That should go pretty quick. And stay tuned for the rest. And just keep up with the modeling, and you could always build your own engine. So thank you guys, and thanks for watching. And I surely do appreciate it. Please subscribe. Please subscribe. I'm going to try to get to 20,000 subscribers by the end of the year. At least that's what I hope. So, and if you're interested in dovetail cutters, please email me. I do have dovetail cutters. So email me and I'll send you the information. Thank you, and thanks for watching.